Hey everybody, thanks for coming back to Stamping School. I've got an oversized special card and it's a pop-up on the inside and it's using a new bundle that's coming out in March. So it's called Butterfly Bouquet. So I'm gonna show you how to do the pop-up inside. I'm gonna show you all the stuff that's coming so you can see it up close. And then we will make the fun fold. So on the front, our friendship isn't one big thing. It's a million little things. And I love it because it's just, it's so her. She loves butterflies. And I wanted something kind of over the top, you know, special. So I hope she likes it. The last time I did this pop-up, it's called a V pop-up, was back in 2007. I went through my videos to see when the last time I did it. And I did a little Valentine with a heart coming up just right here. So I thought, well, why not do it on the bottom too? That's kind of fun. So, and then of course, everything closes up nice and tidy. And I'll show you how to do it. So this bundle is going to be in the Stampin' Up! New Annual Catalog in May. They always do this every year around March or April. They come out with a bundle that's kind of a pre-release, so it's something you can get your hands on early. Demonstrators can get it this month, and then next month customers can get it. And you don't have to rush on it because it is coming in the annual catalog. However, there's a paper that goes with it that you're going to want to see. And that's not going into the annual catalog, so you may want to pick that up if you think you might get this later. So the stamp set is huge. It is one big rubber stamp set with the butterflies right here. And then there's a die that will cut them all out at once. And that is really fun because you can just get all of these done at one time, and we love that. Now this is bigger than a regular A2 size card here in the US. So this is 4.25 by 5.5, which is a regular A2 size card. And you can tell it would hang over the edge, which there's nothing wrong with that. But when we do this project, I'm making a bigger card that's almost 5 by 7, just because I wanna really take advantage of all these butterflies. So you can stamp them all at once, and then you can cut them all at once, like I did right here. And you can look at the detail on them. They're kind of like ink sketch. They have this great texture to them. And then the dies, in addition to this one, there's 11 more, and they're all intricate like this. And then there's two little solid ones. And then they also have these little background guys that look like this. You kind of put them on your paper any way you want to. And it, you know, there's a little cross hatch, and there's bricks, and there's little splatters, whatever, little guys. See that? So there are 12 dies all together, and these are very intricate. In fact, they're so intricate, when I ran them through the machine, I went through once, then I went back through again, and one more just to make sure, because they are so intricate, and I tried to cut all of them at once, and I was having trouble. So it's better if you just do a few of them at a time, roll through, roll back, because they are just to get all the little pieces out. But aren't they pretty? And you can also cut something solid out of this, and then these will all fit because all of these match the same shapes. So it's very, very versatile. There's a flyer. I'll put it over on my blog if you want to see all the prices for everything. And there's a whole suite. There's also this interesting natural touch specialty paper. Let me show you. It kind of reminds me of linoleum. It's very thin. It just is a real interesting buttery wood color paper, and there's texture on it. Oh, can we see this on camera? I don't know. Oh, you can hear it. It's got this wood grain that runs through it, and then the paper. This is the paper I was saying. Get it in March if you think that you might want to get that bundle later, because this paper is the one that the die fits on. So check this out. This die cuts out all these butterflies at one time. So, you know, I lined it up real good. I put a little bit of painter's tape on the edges to make sure, and they all cut out. So you've got ready to go butterflies. Now, if you don't have a machine, then you can fussy cut them. The paper's still pretty. And the best part is that there are 6 designs, but you get 8 sheets of that, of the 6, and there it comes 6x6, but you get 8 of those. So you can get 6 butterflies times 8 sheets, 48 butterflies out of one pack. So here's all the designs. This one, I really like this one. I don't know, it could be sympathy, it could be birthday, it could be anything. Like, I love this paper right here. And then sort of a gradated rainbow almost of different colors of butterflies. This one is a bunch of splotches. And then this one has pinks and greens. And then the other side, of course, they always do tone on tone in the Bermuda Bay and the different colors. Oh, a little more butterflies. Look at that. Pretty. Pretty. Very pretty. This side will never get used because I'll always be cutting that side out. And then that. So that's the paper, 48 sheets of that. So now we got that out of the way. Let's work on this pop-up card. So, hey, if you want to make a Valentine's Day card with some hearts on it and you open it up and it just explodes with hearts, this would be a great layout for that too. The front of this card I did on crumb cake. I stamped it with Versamark and then I embossed it with clear embossing powder. I found that it was best to really do it with a Stamparatus or whatever kind of stamp positioner that you have, but it's really hard to get all of these inked up well at one time. Versamark is that sticky, sticky ink that you're gonna use to put your powder on so it all sticks, okay? And I found that I had to do it 2 times to get it really good and inky, to make sure that it's really, really strongly inked. That's not bad. Make sure your pad is inked too. We have refills for the Versamark, so make sure it's juicy. All right, but I missed a little bit right there. So I'm gonna make sure that I get it nice and inked up. It's a big one. Okay, then I poured clear powder all over it, tapped it off and heated it with a heat tool. And of course that's pretty just the way it is. But when you emboss it, you love them a little more. Look, makes them all shiny and pretty. Here's what it looked like with just stamping with crumb cake on crumb cake and then doing black down here. It's fine, it's nice. And this little guy, you know, when you add the one, our friendship isn't one big thing, which is, this is the one big thing right here. You know, it's a million little things. But it's fine. If you want to just stamp it with tone on tone or something and then just do black, that it had a little bit of black in here. I thought that was going to work fine, but then I just needed it to be a little bit more. So this is the front of the card. And there's this really pretty gold ribbon that's in the January through June catalog. So we're going to do that, pick up a little bit of gold, put that down here, and this will go on the card. The most important thing that I want to show you is how to do that V-fold. So I'm going to skip showing you how to emboss this with gold powder because I think you know how to do that. But that stamp set is an older one from the annual catalog called Beauty Abounds. And it's got the Our Friendship Isn't One Big Thing. It's a million little things. So that's where I got that from. So I'm using So Saffron as my card base. And it is 10 inches wide. Score in half at 5 inches, and it's only 6.5 inches tall. I want to make a 5x7 card, but this just looked better on the 6.5. So I cut off a half of an inch and it sort of balanced everything. If you don't have an envelope for a 5x7 and you don't have the envelope maker, you can take apart and make a template out of a 5x7 envelope that maybe somebody gave you, mailed you. You might have one if you don't have the envelope maker, but you can easily make a template for that because I know Stampin' Up! Doesn't sell the 5x7. I wish they did, but I frequently use 5x7s because I just like how big they are. Okay, so when the card is folded, it's 5 inches by 6.5. So we have that glued on. So we're going to take this biggest butterfly and it's just going to sit right on top right here. I've got dimensionals on him. And then this greeting will go here and I just tied on a little bit of linen thread. So that's the front. Now let's do the inside. So we need a piece of crumb cake to go on the inside. All right, you're gonna need something foamy that you can score on, or a mouse pad, anything that has a little bit of give to it. Okay. I'm gonna show you how to do this on white cardstock so you can see it better. But your paper needs to start out at 6 1/4 by 9 1/2, and then we're gonna score it in half here at 4 3/4, right? And that's gonna make that fit just right inside the card. So you can see how that would layer down nicely in there. Now, to do these little guys right here, two different ways. I'll show you my original way and then a little workaround that I thought was even better. So it really doesn't matter how wide these are. I mean, at least an inch, but you can go even wider, and I'll show you what that looks like on the card. So what we need to do is create this V like this on each end. So if you can take your ruler, and I just do it with the score because I don't want to leave ink on it, because you're going to see it, or use a pencil so you can erase it. You want to mark 1 inch from the center seam this way and 1 inch this way, and kind of make a little mark. And then you can come down 2 1/2 inches or 3 or whatever you want. This can be as long as you want. I just wanted them to kind of, you know, have a little space in the middle, but to kind of be equal. So I went 2 1/2 inches down, made a little mark, and then you're going to score, and this is where it's helpful if you got a mouse pad or something underneath it. You can score right here, from here to here, and from this 1 inch mark to here. Now, what I found was, if I was off just a wee bit, it made it, I had an extra crease here. So I have a little bit of a workaround on it, which I think is gonna actually even be easier. So this is my new way to do it, which I actually like better. So here's my score line for the middle of the card. I'm gonna fold it, and then I'm gonna come over an inch from here, make a little mark. Remember, do yours in pencil so you can erase it, okay? And then come down your 2 1/2 inches, make a little mark again in pencil, okay? So there's my two little marks. Now, just come in here, line up your ruler and get a little stylus or a pen that doesn't work, or a bone folder, just something that you can score with from here to here, and give it a little impression a few times like that. Okay, so see my little mark right there? Now when I turn this over, I can actually see it. I can actually see it from here, and when you do it, you're gonna be able to see it also. And I'm just gonna do the same on the other side. Follow that original crease. Then I'm gonna fold it here and then fold it back. And that's gonna make an even V fold. More even than when I measure and bring it down and bring it down, because this could meet in just a little bit different area. So you try both methods. You let me know what you think. But I think this is working pretty good. So bone folder really helps it to be nice and crisp each way, okay? And then when you open it up, you pop it, pop that little V in like this. So you just gotta work it. And there it is. So now you've got your little V. So what I did on this one is I decided, well, why not just do it a little bit wider? So instead of just doing an inch, I went in 1 1/2 inches and made it wider on the bottom. So I've got a deeper V over here. So I've got a little one up here and then a deeper one down here. So I thought I'd just see how that looks. Now I thought I would use some of those dies to kind of give it a little interest in here. So I ran that through and it barely fit through my machine at 6 1/4. It just, ooh, scraped the sides, but it fit. And I just laid those down here. And now we are ready to glue in and then decorate. All right. So we're gonna start just around the edges. Don't get the glue in between there. And I don't do in the center just because I think it creates some issues. So I just go all the way around. And this is gonna be a nice layer. So you wanna position it so the layer is nice and even all the way around. Don't worry if that doesn't line up perfectly. It's not gonna matter. And then we do the same thing on this side, and here, right here, and close the book. There it is. It's got just the right amount of give right there. So it opens up just the way we want. So it looks like a little bird on this side, this side. Now this one folds flat a little bit more, but it's not gonna fold flat this way because it's got that V in. Had we went right into the corner, it would have been a little bulky, and it also would have, but it would have folded flat, but it would have been a little bulky. So we're gonna keep it right there and decorate it. And this is where we can bring all those really great butterflies in that I pre-cut. I have glue dots on them. And on the paper, designer paper ones, I have a little wink of Stella on them to kind of make them pop. And then I'll show you how to put these on. I'm gonna save these two. Doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna save those two for the pop-ups. Another one, aren't they fun? They're just fun to just kind of scatter around a little bit. Moved them around a little bit. Okay, when it comes time to doing these guys, you only want to put the glue on the wing. So, and it can come above your card here because it's going to fold down when you close it. So if you have the mini dimensionals, those work really great. They hold really well and they're not too big. So for the little butterfly, I have it in the upper left-hand corner and it's gonna go up here, right there on the left-hand side. So like I said, don't worry if it hangs over. It's gonna close. You just wanna make sure it doesn't get caught in anything. So on this one, dimensional on the upper right-hand side, and I'm gonna put it on the right-hand side of the V, and I'm gonna position him down a little bit so when he comes up, he's got a place to go. And then I've got my It's a Million Things that can go here. So then after we've got all that on there, we can decorate it with some sequins or rhinestones or whatever. And on this one, I even added a few gold butterflies. There's some little solid ones that are in that set. So I just did just a little shiny and just scattered some sequins around. Oh, that's it. I hope she likes it. All right, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.